And hello, YouTube, and welcome back to another episode of The Zone TV Movie Entertainment. Well, it's Wednesday night, so that means Arrow is back. Season 5 premiered tonight, and oh boy, did I get a lot of deja vu in this premiere episode. Season 5, episode 1. So basically, first of all, let me start by saying this. I don't know how, you know, close the team of the writers of Arrow and Flash are with each other. But man, a lot of these moments in this episode was point by point by point, the Flash paradox. It was just bizarre in a weird, strange way, from the way that the team changed to the new villain. It was the way that they take down the villain. It was just bizarre. Very creepy. But this episode actually was a lot better than I thought for premiere than the Flash. But, okay, so basically now with new changes, spoiler alert, so you'll be warned. And, basically now we got Mayor Queen. Now Stephen Amell, who plays Oliver Queen, he is the new mayor of Central City. So now he's the new mayor, and everything's hunky-dory, basically, except for a couple of things here or there, basically, now that he's in charge of being, you know, the mayor of the city now. He has no team. The team is gone. Fias doesn't want to do the thing anymore. Diggle has left the team. And except just basically him and Felicity. So now they have run the whole thing themselves, while him being mayor and playing Green Arrow at the same time. So, and then of course we get a new bad guy. The guy whose name is Churchill, something like that. Anyway, he was pretty cool. For a big, tough, you know, I want to say maybe, mobster, kind of. But all he wanted, basically, was to challenge the Arrow. And boy, he did. So, anyway. Like I said, I like this episode. It was pretty cool. But it was really dark, this episode. I think this has been darker than so of what season 4, season premiere, was. So, I really dug that. The fight sequences look a lot better in this one than in season 4. We get a couple of new characters in here. I mean, we got the character Wild Dog. We only saw him in the beginning of the episode, but we're gonna get more into him, you know, as season goes on, hopefully. We got to see, finally get to hear what Laurel said at the end of season 4 before she died to Oliver, basically saying that she had to promise me that there'll be another canary, somebody there as another canary to take her place, but at least she knows that she's with him and the team. So I thought that was pretty cool. For me, what didn't work in this episode was, honestly, it just really felt like the Flash paradox, where basically everything changed in the beginning, just like in the Flash. They get a new bad guy, they take him down really quick, and basically, now the big new threat comes out the end of it. It was just really bizarre how this whole thing just happened. But yeah, I still dug it. Good laughs. What else? We get to see what Laurel's father has been doing. He's no longer with the police department. And he's just basically helping the team by the sidelines, I guess. But you know, as the season goes on, we'll see more with him, probably. We didn't get to see Diggle until the very end of the show, because Oliver needed to talk to him about if he should even make a new team, because Felicity kept bugging him, and that's what she likes to do, bug the heroes by getting a new team, and he's like, no. I thought that was pretty cool. What I didn't like about the episode, besides the whole copying the Flashpoint, like, beat by beat, was just bizarre. Some of the angles of, you know, with the shaky cam, in my opinion, just looked kind of weird. With the cams, the fight sequences looked a little bit better, but it could be improved more, you know what I mean? But I still dug this episode. I cannot wait to see more. I really, really like Arrow. It's a really great show. I think Stephen Amell played Oliver Queen's perfection. And of course, we did get to see some of the flashbacks of him in Russia now, so at least that. You know, he's now in Russia. In the beginning of the flashback, we see him kind of like Jason Bourne style, fighting like in a cage fight, but not really in a cage fight, more like underground fights. Just whooping people's butts like he always does, and yeah, looking pretty jacked. So, I just hope the flashbacks make more sense, and hopefully, eventually, this could be the end of the flashbacks. I know a lot of people are starting to get tired of the flashbacks because they just want him to finally go back all the way around to the island and how he gets out of there. So, hopefully, let's see. But so far, so good. I really dug this episode. Can't wait to see more. It's going to be fun. And, yeah, let's hope it just keeps going. Because I think Arrow right now is the strongest show. So let's see what happens with Flash now, and then Legends is next week, and Supergirl. So I'm looking forward to those two shows. So leave a comment below and let me know what you guys think about this first episode of Season 5 of Arrow. And, yeah, thank you and have a good night.